Sega. For the past 45 years, Iron Man has thrilled fans around the world as part of comic book lore. But now, the man in the iron suit of armor is about to take on his biggest audience, moviegoers.
If you were to invent a character that was the perfect character for a video game, you would come up with Iron Man. And luckily, Stan Lee already did.
What Marvel is really good at is they're really taking care to not only preserve, you know, what the fans like, but doing things to make it appeal to a wider range of audience, stuff that everybody can relate to. And that's the thing with all these comic books, is that they always have these general, fundamental human kind of, you know, sensibilities, and, you know, bring them out to a wider range of public who wouldn't necessarily go into the comic store, but they'll watch a movie, you know, and the same people will probably end up, you know, playing the video games.
Designing a Nintendo Wii game around Iron Man's many varied abilities and powers provides interesting gameplay experiences, but also presents some interesting development challenges.
Yeah, it's actually hugely difficult. I think one of the things that makes Iron Man so compelling but also makes him difficult is he can do so much. He can fly, he's got super strength, he's got, you know, the armor shield, the unit beam, the repulsor blast, all these different things. You've got to balance gameplay for all those things.
Most important thing for programming on the Wii is making the gameplay feel intuitive for the players.
Iron Man flies around, so we're going to have to look at opening the environments, creating a little more open, less linear.
Anybody can come up with any crazy idea. It's more fun to do it when you're like, okay, no, I can't go there. This is the box that's defined for me. Okay, let's see how far I can push that box while staying in that box.
We can't really load and unload parts of levels when your character can fly everywhere and go everywhere and see everywhere at the same time. So that's been the biggest challenge for sure.
There's a lot more physicality in our experience. You're going to be able to punch just like you're going to punch with Iron Man. You're going to fly around by pointing the Wiimote in the screen.
With the game design in place for the Nintendo Wii, the next step for the developers at A2M in Montreal was to meet with the filmmakers and incorporate the look and feel of the film into the game.
There was a lot of back and forth, and we're trying to push that even further between the film team and the game team. I think it's, you know, it's customary for the game team to sit there and wait for the assets and have the film team dictate, but I think the Iron Man film team has been very collaborative and very interested.
Fortunately, we were working on this movie for a long enough time that we could get assets to them early enough on that it could actually inform the design of the game.
Creating a game based on a character from the pages of a comic book allows Montreal-based developer A2M to pull from the vast Marvel library, enabling them to further expand on the film and thoroughly explore the world of Iron Man.
The movie is a two-hour experience, and we're providing an experience that's a lot longer than that.
There was a lot of pre-production stuff that, you know, we got to see in reference that I think is going to influence the game in one way or another. I think there's a lot of missions that have, things that were, there were early set-piece action battles that got changed or scaled back. There were, you know, some, you know, like all movies, there's a lot of script changes and a lot of character changes and that sort of thing. And so we took a lot of that early inspiration. Some of it may not end up in the movie, but is definitely driving some of the missions that we have. And so that's very exciting.
One of the things we're doing is we're digging a little bit deeper into the whole Tony Stark Iron Man mythos. We're bringing back old enemies. We're bringing back characters that are very important to Tony Stark.
As part of the development process, A2M received feedback from not only Marvel, but from the film's director and star.
Other research included meeting the actors, meeting the film crew, talking with Jon Favreau, Robert Downey Jr., getting their take on how they saw Iron Man.
And the first thing I noticed was how true the actual character designs and movement and even controls were to what was in the movie.
It's a ton of work to make anything ever look cool. And the amount of man hours and ingenuity and just kind of 99% perspiration of it all.
Taking their cue from their big screen counterpart, Montreal-based developer A2M starts players off with the birth of Iron Man and his bulky gray armor.
I was never satisfied with the Iron Man costume in the comics. As longtime readers will know, because every few issues I'd have the artist change the costume. He must have had more costume changes, more armor changes than any character in the world.
You start in a very basic suit, and it's all about upgrades. And as you're going through the game, you're building this suit and making it better and adding stuff to it, adding layers to it.
I think the Mark I suit from the film, I think they've done an amazing job updating what, you know, the old classic tin can. I think my, you know, the classic 60s gray tin can can Iron Man outfit is definitely my favorite, but I love how they've updated it.
If only we had had that kind of armor in the comic books, I think the book would have sold twice as well. I love it. I love the way Iron Man looks. I love the way you have him fly. I love the way he shoots those repulsor rays. I mean, oh, man.
In order to bring these characters to life, Sega and A2M were able to enlist many of the film stars to reprise their roles.
Well, I think the luckiest thing that happened was getting Robert Downey Jr. to play Tony Stark. That guy was born to be Tony Stark. When I first saw him with his little beard and everything, the way Tony has it, oh, man, that was so gratifying.
I studied these three scenes for the screen test within an inch of my life. I went so absolutely ape turds prepping myself to do these three scenes. No one else really had a prayer.
In addition to Robert Downey Jr., Sean Toob returns to play Yinsen.
Yinsen is basically, I consider him to be the creator of Iron Man. He starts his journey.
And Oscar nominee Terrence Howard plays Tony Stark's best friend, James Rhodes.
Doing it for the video game, you're trying to perceive what might be the end result, you know, and you can't be too sure. So it's a little more nerve-wracking and as far as the level of performance that you output.
Regardless of the techniques and tools involved, the combined efforts of Sega, A2M, Marvel, and the filmmakers promise to deliver a truly unique superhero game and one for a character who is long overdue.
My publisher at the time said, Stan, you're crazy. Nobody's going to want to read about a guy who makes weapons for war, and people don't like wealthy heroes. A guy who flaunts his wealth and he's a playboy. I said, we'll make them like him. And it worked.